Halo students, all are feeling better now and are you all ready for your class? I am Gagini teacher and I will be your class teacher too. So, as you all know, I am your biology teacher. Okay? So, the first chapter of our biology subject is Protectors of Biosphere. Protectors of Biosphere. So when we say biosphere, we all know the meaning of biosphere. Biosphere means the place where life is supported, or it is the sphere in the earth where life is possible. Why? Because of the availability of oxygen, availability of the water, climatic conditions, etc. So in this chapter, we are going to study what is biosphere and how we will have to act to protect and sustain the biosphere in a good condition. So now, first thing which we have to discuss in this chapter is about the plants. As you all know, plants are very important to us. Why? Why plants are important to us? You all know that plants are the organisms which provide us oxygen to breathe. The basic need of our life is oxygen. Oxygen is very essential to breathe. So as such, you all know that plants, or without plants, survival of human life is not possible. We take in oxygen from plants and we give out carbon dioxide, which will be utilized by the plants for photosynthesis. And do you all know what is the term? What do you mean by photosynthesis? What do you mean by photosynthesis? Right from the lower classes we are discussing, or we were discussing, about photosynthesis. As you all know that photosynthesis is the process where we plants are preparing food. Utilizing what are the four factors essential for photosynthesis? The first and the foremost thing is, what are the four factors which is very essential for photosynthesis? One is water. Plants need carbon dioxide, then sunlight, and of course chlorophyll. And when I say chlorophyll, you all will know that chlorophyll is seen only in green plants. Or we can say that only green plants can prepare their own food. So photosynthesis can be defined as the process by which green plants prepare their food in the presence of sunlight, water, carbon dioxide, and of course chlorophyll, which is a green pigment present in the green plants. Right, children? So now, next we will have to discuss about the structure of chloroplast. What do you mean by chloroplast? What is the structure of chloroplast is what we are going to discuss next. So the first part of it you have understood,